rain's holding off a little bit. It started to drizzle and had us a little bit worried for camera gear reasons, but it's holding out, so we're still looking for a buck today. And I think Ryan and I, we're gonna cruise back around this road and drop down into here. I want to get down there and look over this peak, and there's a nice draw down there, and it's all within muzzleloader distance, I think, about 100-120 yards.
Just a good sign that we're up here in the coast range. Find these little critters all over the place. Yeah, I'm gonna let them go.
There you go, little buddy. Well, the weatherman was right. They called for 100% rain today, and it's 9 o'clock in the morning now, and it's finally coming down. Ryan and I, we came down this trail. We've seen a bunch of fresh tracks up on top, and figured we'd hike this trail out, and we get to the end, you can see, and what do you know? There's definitely a buck working in this area. Alright, so Ryan and I, we just got back from a nice little hike down this trail here. Man, what a change in weather. This morning was absolutely beautiful, with the sunrise coming over Mount Hood and fog in the valleys, and a couple hours later, here we are, typical coast range rain. No wind still, but it's raining. We're gonna get wet, and that leads me to, I just wanted to explain to you guys, I'm hunting traditional muzzleloader. I mean, it's a Remington 700. It's not necessarily traditional, but Oregon rules says you have to shoot open ignition and open sights. No scopes. You can't shoot. You have to use the musket caps, so it's kind of different than a primer, but so it's exposed to the weather at all times. So I mean, even a little bit of water can really screw you up. If your powder gets wet, or if your percussion cap gets wet, it's not gonna fire. So I'm taking a lot of precautions right now to keep this covered with my hand. The next trip out, I'm gonna put like a little rubber deal over the top of the barrel to try and keep the rain out. But this muzzleloader and stuff, it's a lot of fun, but there's a lot of maintenance involved, and it's a lot different than rifle hunting. The season's awesome. We're here in the rut, but the weather is definitely going to play a role in this hunt.
About a half hour ago, cross the creek and come up in this area. We're kind of on a point now. I think it's a good idea to try and rattle. Unfortunately, I don't have my real horns. I just got this little rattle bag, but I've been successful in rattling in bucks with this before, so.
So as you guys can see, we got beautiful, beautiful weather right now. We got the sun coming up still, and unfortunately the forecast is calling for 100% downpour
substantial amount of rain for the next couple days, so we're gonna take advantage of this weather and head down the ridge and hopefully get into some other cuts that I think are gonna hold some deer. Just absolutely breathtaking views, as you guys could see right now. This is as good as it gets.
Oh, yes. he's done. I nailed him. Oh, he's done. Look at that, buddy. It happened.
We just did it.
We did it. Muzzleloader, public land. Barrett behind the camera. Freaking. Oh, dude, he's dead. He's.
I can't believe it.
Yeah!
Yeah, yeah.
Getting closer.
So stoked right now. I'm 15 yards from putting my hands on this buck. And I can't wait.
Wow. I did it finally. What a big buck. And a perfect shot.
It's awesome looking. Muzzleloader hunt up here in Northwest Oregon Coast Range. A little bit longer shot than I thought. I estimated 100 yards and turns out it was more like 130. What an awesome shot with an open sight muzzleloader. We've been working all morning long, hoping for this guy to show himself, and we hiked, and Barrett and I, we just hiked all over the place and rattled a bunch and nothing was happening. We seen one buck this morning for about 0.5 seconds and seen two other does. Then I
told him I wanted to come over here to a different area, and we went out to it, pulled out on a logging landing, and grabbed the muzzleloader and the camera, and what'd it take, Baird? About 5 minutes of just glassing, and all of a sudden...
I don't even think it was that long.
A few minutes of glassing, and all of a sudden, I look right down below. He was bedded down right here, 10 yards from where we're sitting right here. And he was just bedded down broadside looking at us, and Barrett got the camera ready and did a great job there, and I made the perfect shot, and this is absolutely awesome. Dream come true, and I'm sold, man. I'm a hardcore muzzleloader hunter now.